This is a particular product that Joel from Race Spec Online has produced himself, seeing a hole in the market. This is his SS 1.0 solid contacts for the Superseal connectors. So these connectors, I'll show this under our overhead in a moment. These are probably one of the more common connectors we come across in the aftermarket ECU world. They're used by the likes of MoTeC, Haltech, Link, FuelTech, just to name a few, and there's a good reason why they are so popular as well. They are easy to work with, they are relatively immune from moisture and dust ingress, and they're relatively cost effective. So for us in the aftermarket, it's really a no-brainer. The aftermarket has also come up with options for back shells that go on these connectors so that you can actually boot them and get a completely sealed harness, adding to that professional finish as well as doing a little bit more strain relief. Now, the problem with these, well, I wouldn't say it's a problem, but particularly if you're doing a lot of them, comes down to the tooling and the terminals that go along with them. So this one I'll get under our overhead, and we have gone quite tight with our overhead here so I can really show you what we're dealing with. This is the typical contact that you're going to get when you're working with one of these connectors. So if you buy a connector set from one of those ECU manufacturers I just mentioned, you're going to get a bunch of these little terminals. Nothing specifically wrong with them. Yes, they can work quite nicely. And again, we're getting quite tight here. We've actually got two aspects to this particular terminal. This little part here, this little U-channel, this is what we actually crimp down onto the conductor strands. And then at the back, we've got another two little tangs here. And these are crimped down onto the insulation around our conductor. So to do that, generally, we're going to be using a generic tool, crimp tool like this one here, and this makes the use of that particular contact or terminal a two crimp operation. What we're going to do is first of all crimp down onto the conductor strands, and then we're going to need to crimp down onto the actual insulation. Now, I'm going to try and do this. As I said, I've got the overhead quite tight, so please give me a little bit of leeway here if it doesn't work quite how it should, but we'll see what we can do. I'll get everything ready and we'll go to our overhead here. So what I've done, obviously I've got the terminal located in our crimp tool. I've already stripped a little bit of insulation off our wire here. We'll get that installed, and we want to make sure that the conductor is completely installed into our little U-channel there. Decent crimp down on that. So that's our first operation done there. You can get that out, and we can see under our overhead, we've got full engagement of our copper, our conductor, and everything's looking quite nice there. So then what we have to do is basically get our tool flipped around here, and we're going to do the second part of our operation here. And we're not trying to pierce the insulation here, we're just trying to crimp down there, and that's going to support the insulation at the back of that terminal. So I mean, it didn't take me very long, but of course, when you're doing a lot of these, which you will be if you are building a harness for an aftermarket ECU, this becomes a really tedious and monotonous process. There are also some disadvantages with that particular terminal. So let's get the race spec contact under our overhead here. So that's what we've got here. It is a solid one-piece contact. It is a closed barrel design. And if I roll this around here, just like we see with a lot of the professional autosport connector contacts, that style of contact, we've got a little inspection hole in here. Why that's important is that it allows inspection to make sure that we've got full engagement of our conductor strands inside that contact. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, well, okay, so what? Well, the advantage with this is that we get away from using that generic crimp tool. We get away from the two crimp operation. Instead, what we're going to be using is a DMC industry standard crimp tool. This is an MH680, and that works in conjunction with another bespoke product that Joel from Race Spec's made, which is the positioner. Anyone who has worked with the autosport connectors before will be familiar with these. Let's get it under our overhead here. I'll just get our little contact out of the way. So this is the DMC crimp tool here, and this is designed to crimp numerous different contacts. So depending on the contact that we're working with, we will have a positioner that goes in the end here, locates nicely just like that, and that does exactly what its name suggests. It positions the contact so that the crimp is going to be located correctly in the right place on that particular contact. Now, the particular contacts that Joel has made here are suitable for 16 gauge through to 24 gauge, and we can see here there are selector positionings based on the gauge of wire that we are using. All right, so what we'll do is, again, we'll awkwardly try and demonstrate this under our overhead, and we'll see how that goes. First of all, what I'll do is just strip a little bit of insulation off another piece of wire here, and we'll get the contact located. And we want a little bit of free conduct at the end here anyway, and that prevents any strain being placed into the contact. With that in location, and I have already got my setting correct for this is 22 gauge wire, so we're on 7, and we'll just locate that in. And then it's just a simple crimp operation. Job done. So much, much quicker than the crimp operation that you originally saw. So then what we can do is we can take our Superseal connector, and by just pressing down on the little white tab on the bottom, that unlocks it. We hear a nice click, and we can simply push that contact in from the back. And again, we feel a nice positive click when that's in place. You can close it down, and we're done. Now, it is recommended with these contacts as well to run a backshell and a boot to help with strain relief. Some other advantages with these, of course, they are gold plated, as you can clearly see, and this generally offers improved conductivity. Obviously, a good thing when we are talking about aftermarket ECUs. The system exceeds the amperage rating of the Superseal system, so that's again not a bad thing, particularly if you are pushing the boundaries there. Race Spec have tested these to 100 mating cycles. Now, this is something we don't often think about. And one of the problems with a lot of the factory connectors we come across on engines is that they're really not designed to be installed and removed numerous times. They're really sort of a one and done style of thing. So particularly we tend to see that if the sensors are plugged in and unplugged numerous times, the sensor can start to lose its grip, or basically won't necessarily mate as nicely. This also goes for products like the Superseal connector. So Race Spec have tested these to 100 mating cycles, which should be absolutely ample. Minimal loss of performance. There are some specs on the website if you want to dive into that and get a little bit more specific. So obviously this does require some tooling. The actual contacts themselves, of course, are going to be more expensive than the ones that will come with the Superseal connectors themselves, which I already showed you. Goes without saying though, I mean, you do get what you pay for. If you want to up your game and provide a more professional result, these are an excellent product. I've been using them in our latest dash install with a MoTeC dash and really enjoyed how easy they were to work with. And of course, if you are doing this for a living, it's going to end up saving you quite a significant amount of time. If you do want to find out more, I'll jump across to my laptop screen. There is a Race Spec SS1.0 solid contact entry level starter kit. It's a bit of a mouthful, $587. So as I said, it's definitely not going to be for the entry level hobbyist just getting started, but for those who want to up their game, this particularly in its time saving will pay for itself. So this includes everything you need, and you can check that out on the Race Spec online website.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.